Subscribe this channel by pressing this button for being updated from Biomedical and Healthcare Society. Hello guys, welcoming you all in another episode of Weekly Tech Updates. I am Amit and you are watching Techomed. So without any further delay, let's get started. The very first update is about ultrasound imaging needle, which can be a big transform in heart surgeries. Researchers in London have been completely published details of a revolutionary new cardiology needle capable of imaging the heart's shock tissue from within. The team from University College London and Queen's Mary University of London used the new all-optical ultrasound imaging system for heart surgeries in pigs, successfully capturing high-resolution images up to 2.5 cm away from the needle tip. For the first time, live imaging can now be taken directly from inside the heart during keyhole surgery, which has the potential of offering vast improvements over current practices. With surgeons really on pre-operative imaging combined with external ultrasound probe, the optical ultrasound needle is perfect for procedure where there is a small tissue target that is hard to see during keyhole surgery. Using current methods and missing it could have disastrous consequences. Outside of cardiology, the imaging system has many potential uses in a variety of minimally invasive procedures, and it even opens up the possibility of futuristic applications such as in-womb surgeries. The team of researchers behind the technology are now planning towards translating that system for clinical use in patients. The another update is about nanoparticles Laden drug, which can stop the cancer stem cell. Researchers at the University of Illinois are working on preventing the metastasis of the cancer by using nanoparticles Laden with drug to deactivate cancer stem cells. Cancers often spread via cancer stem cells that can reappear and grow new tumors long after a patient has been in remission. The therapy was tested on cultures of breast cancer cells as well as on laboratory mice with breast cancer tumors. The findings show that the cancer stem cells are mostly deactivated, preventing them from spreading the disease throughout the rest of the body. Additionally, the general cancer cell count went down in the cultured cell when the model mice. There is a great deal of promise for this technology to be applicable to real-world cancer patients, so they were hoping that it will be soon lead to trials outside the laboratory. The another update is about a vibrator which can detect the protein biomarkers from a disease. Scientists at Spurs University have developed a novel new way of detecting biomarkers within blood and other bodily fluids, potentially opening the possibility of being able to quickly and easily detect a wide variety of diseases and monitor their progress. The technology is rather cheap to manufacture and easy to use, potentially one day making it common for use on the sideline of American football fields and more widely in a variety of clinical applications. Still, research is going on and we are waiting for that product. The another update is about RICOH MAC, that is Magnetoencephalogram, wins the FDA clearance. RICOH, a largest Japanese company, won FDA clearance for its RICOH MAC, that is Magnetoencephalography system. The device is able to detect electrical signals within the brain by measuring the magnetic fields produced as electrical currents move within the brains. According to the company, the device was developed to provide deeper measurement, clearer signals using coaxial radiometer sensors and greater patient comfort for better data acquisition. The another update is about the robotic arms which can now move by the power of thought. Scientists at the University of Chicago have shown that it is possible to implant brain-computer interface and let amputees control robotic arms, even years after their amputations. Similar research has previously focused on paralyzed people and whether they can benefit from technology that lets them move external device by simply willing and thinking of wanted movements. The new development extends a great deal of this research to amputees. Brain is incredibly adaptive and neuroplasticity can be harnessed to help restore lost function and train brain regions to perform tasks they were never intended to perform. So that's all about the weekly tech updates from Biomedical and Healthcare Society. If you have any query or suggestion, you can ask me in comment section. I will answer every question over there. If you have not subscribed to this channel, you can do it by pressing this button, because I used to come up with various types of videos related to Biomedical Engineer weekly. Do like the video and share this video with others. So this is Amit Mohan Raman signing out. Check it.